South Australians are waking up with a new Premier this morning, Labor's Peter Malinauskas, beating Liberal's Stephen Marshall for the top job. The question now, will the upcoming federal election fall the same way? Premier-elect Peter Malinauskas joins us now from Adelaide. Peter, a huge congratulations to you. How's victory feeling this morning?
Good morning, Ali. Incredibly busy. It's been a whirlwind of a couple of days, but you know, I feel incredibly humbled by the support that the people of our state have invested in me and my team, and we're excited about going through the official process and then getting on with the job as quickly as we can.
Look, you campaign pretty hard on local issues such as fixing the ambulance crisis. Do you think it was local issues alone that determined this election, or did federal issues play a role?
Look, to the extent that there's a comparison to be made between state and federal, I think it's this. As we sort of, as a nation, move into the next phase coming out of the pandemic, I really believe there is a hope and an aspiration that the legacy of COVID for our country is going to be a fairer society, that it's not just going to be a big debt and a bad memory, but rather a moment in time where, as a people, we come together and say, well, what's next? What's the future of our home going to look like on the back of the pandemic? And I was very determined to tap into that opportunity and that sentiment during the course of the campaign, and we've developed an agenda to realise that chance and this special moment in time. And I think the federal election presents a similar opportunity for the rest of the country, and I know ABO's committed to delivering on that.
Look, and as you would know, your federal counterparts, Anthony Albanese, is dealing with a bullying crisis right now. He's refused to hold a full inquiry. Is that something that you would push him to do? Do you think it's a good idea?
Oh, look, it's not for me to tell ABO what to do. He'll make his own judgments based on the information that he's got before him. The person who I probably know best who's been in party to all of this, of course, is Penny Wong. And I know Penny well enough to know that she's a really decent person, and she's made on Channel 9 an admission and a verdict that she made. And I think that speaks to her character. You know, politicians are human. When they make mistakes or act in a way that isn't appropriate, you acknowledge it, you apologise for it, you correct your behaviour and you move on. And
do you think that goes far enough, though?
And Penny's a fine woman.
And I'm not questioning that, but there's, you know, but there are some pretty serious allegations that have been made. Do you not think it should be investigated?
Oh, look, that's a matter for ABO and his team. But like I said, knowing the people involved, I just know their characters, and I do think they're good people, but you have to forgive me, Ali. As you probably appreciate, I've been wholeheartedly immersed in the operations of state government and in the lead up to this state election, and we've been very much focused on that.
Look, we're hearing this morning too that the Treasurer, the Federal Treasurer, is considering a temporary cut to the fuel excise in next week's budget. Is that something you would support?
Naturally. Anything we can do to provide a bit of relief to those at the Bowser is something that I'd support. But I make this point, which is rarely made in Australian politics, I think. Look, politicians don't control prices in a private market. That's the honest truth. Politicians can't control what Vladimir Putin is doing in the Ukraine or what the oligarchs are doing somewhere else. The simple fact is, when it comes to grocery prices and fuel prices, the market determines that price, and government's job is to facilitate competition. So what we've got to do as a country, what we've got to do as leaders around the nation, is to make sure that people's incomes keep pace with the cost of living. And at the moment, what we've seen is declining real wages in many parts of our nation. We've got to have an incomes policy rather than have a, you know, silly argument about how politicians are going to pretend to control prices.
And look, Peter, you know that there is a big federal election coming up. I just want to make sure, are you and Albo okay? Because you didn't take his call at the coffee shop the other day.
We were doing a press event, and Alb and I get on well. It was great to have him in town during the course of the campaign. He was received like a rock star, which is not surprising given his popularity. And he's a good mate, and we get on incredibly well, and we share similar ambitions for the people that we represent.
I get it, mate. I screen Carl's calls all the time.
Yeah.
And I get it. Anyway, congratulations, Peter, on a landslide victory, and good luck with the job ahead.